Action News reporter Marco Villarreal joins us live near the Mandalay Bay, which is where that race started and ended tonight. Marco.
Hey, good evening, Blake. Yeah, I was just looking at a few of the people that just finished the race moments ago. They're on their way back to their hotels to get changed and get dry. It was a very cold day out here. And then to add to it, there was a bit of a drizzle on a lot of the runners out here. But that, honestly, no matter how bad it got out here, there was nothing that could keep these guys from running under the lights of this world famous city. Running a marathon is no easy thing. There's training, stretching, and picking the right costume. At least for those in the Las Vegas Rock and Roll Marathon.
I'm ready to run today.
So is this going to make you faster?
Absolutely. The power of the kill always makes you a lot faster.
And these runners come from all over.
I'm originally from England, but I now live in Columbus, Ohio.
I am from Mexico, from Puebla, Mexico.
We came from Jacksonville, Florida.
In its fourth year, the marathon more than doubled its attendance to 44,000 runners.
We heard about it being a night race. We thought, what better way to come and experience Las Vegas than running a marathon at night? So that's why we're here.
Why did you want to come to Vegas and run this?
Because it's my dream and it's my first marathon, so I think I will be great in this race.
We did it last year when it was in the morning, yeah.
What do you think about having this at nighttime?
I think it's awesome. Running down the strip is awesome. Running back's going to be awesome. And we're going to have a good time and we're going to party on afterwards.
Leaving the starting line at dusk, it doesn't take long for runners to experience the strip lighting their way. Calling all of this a success, organizers are already looking ahead to the future of this event.
Start planning for next year and beyond, because we know if we do it right tonight, then it'll just go, it can go anywhere we want it to after that.
As they get near the end, these athletes get a rock star welcome.
Was it worth it?
It was absolutely worth it. I mean, I've never done a race like this before, a sanctioned event like this, and to do it in Las Vegas, a place as cool as the Strip, you couldn't ask for a better place to do it here than Las Vegas.
And a lot of those runners tonight getting ready to celebrate their accomplishments out here at the casinos, the after parties, and the concerts. And speaking with organizers, they told me earlier that they hope in 2 years' time to make this the largest marathon in the world. Reporting live from the Strip, Marco Villarreal, Channel 13, Action News.
All right, Marco, sounds like a fun event out there. We're looking, though, now at a live traffic camera picture of Tropicana and Las Vegas Boulevard, and it looks like complete gridlock. All of the roads were supposed to be reopened by now. I understand that's not necessarily the case, though.
It depends on what part of the Strip or the Boulevard that you're on. We're told by Metro, I was just talking with them, they say north of Spring Mountain, north and southbound lanes are open. Southbound lanes all the way here to Mandalay Bay Road are open, but barely, really just one lane. So it's still very congested. And then the rest of this area here, from here to Russell Road, is shut down. Metro says they'll probably have this shut down for about another 40 minutes before they have this completely running again. And so if you're going to be coming in the area, try to avoid this for about the next 40 minutes to an hour.
Yeah, looking at those live pictures, it does not look fun. All right, thanks, Marco. And